Okay, here you go. Here's how you set up your boat to flush the engine or run it in the driveway when you're working on it. First off, this is the back seat here under the boat. Ooh, it's starting to rain. Okay, this is the V-drive here. If you've got one like mine, you could do it the same way. When you first look at this, you'll see both sides are going to look just like this. It's an angle fitting screwed into the transmission here, and your hose hooked up over here. This stuff here is what I've added. These are all 1-inch pipe thread fittings. Even the one that's already came with the boat is also pipe thread. NPT. These are 1-inch fittings. This is just a short nipple. The shortest one they have. 1-inch T, all three sides. I've got a 1-inch by 1/2-inch bushing and a 1/2-inch boiler drain. You could buy all this stuff at any hardware store. When you screw it together, make sure that you use Teflon tape and pipe dope. With the tape, I recommend about 5 turns and turn it on, wrap it around there the same way you would if you were going to put a nut on there. That way when you tighten it up, the tape will go inside instead of just unravel. And then when you go to use it, I've got a cap here so no debris ever goes in there. It's just garden hose threads on here. And again, that's a 1/2-inch boiler drain. When you go to use this setup, over here, follow this hose down. Down there is the valve to stop the water from coming back in or out of the boat. This hose goes right through the bottom of the boat. That's the intake hose. Make sure you close that valve so when you hook your garden hose up, the water goes that way and not that way. What I use to hook my hose up, this is a standard washing machine hose, a clothes washing machine. It's got garden hose threads on both ends. And this swivel is here, so you don't have to twist your hose up to screw it on. Hook one end up here, screw your garden hose up into the other end, and you're ready to go. All you gotta do is open this handle up all the way, and it'll let the water right in. And that's it. Turn the garden hose on, wait for the water to come out the tailpipe, and then you can run your engine. But again, make sure you close that valve first. Open this one, and then you're ready to go. When you're done, close this one, put your cap back on, and make sure you open that back up, because if you put your boat in the water and run it, you know it's not going to get any water and you're going to overheat. Good luck, and let me know if you have any trouble.